This video will contain spoilers, so if you and anybody that you're with does not wish to learn how characters die and how the story unfolds, please don't watch this video.
Dankeschön!
Also, a quick note, I will only be talking about the history in this video on the original The Godfather video game. So other versions of this game, such as the Don's Edition and the Black Hand Edition, are dismissed. Aldo Trapani, Don of New York City and brave man. As the main protagonist of the Godfather video game, and making a cameo in the sequel, he's been the main source to the Corleones' dominance. With a dark past and a wonderful character, here's the history of the hero of the Corleone family. Aldo Trapani is voiced by Amanda Moody, Andrew Pivko and Rick Pasqualone. He was born in Little Italy in 1924 to Serafina and Johnny Trapani. The earliest incident we have with Aldo is in 1936, witnessing his father's murdered by a patrol of Barzinis under the command of Don Emilio Barzini. By 1945, Aldo joins a gang who stole goods in which he would be their getaway driver. His mother had a deep concern for her son, in which she visited Don Corleone on the day of his daughter's wedding to help her son. So Don Corleone sent informant Luca Brasi to rescue Aldo from getting beaten up by his gang over money problems. Then afterwards, Luca Brasi met up with Aldo and taught him how to extort businesses and take over rackets. Later on, Brasi sent Aldo to meet up with two other upcomers, Paul Legato and Marty Malone. In the third mission of the first game, Aldo assists with Paulie and Marty to avenge on two college students for the beating of Amerigo Bonasara's daughter Marie. Shortly after the vengeance, Don Corleone set up a serious task for Luca Brasi to pretend he's not happy with the Corleones and join the Tattaglias to find out Solazzo and Bruno Tattaglia's plans. Aldo tagged along with Luca and watched Brasi's murder due to Bruno and Solazzo being informed about being lied to. After Luca is garroted to death, Aldo kills Luca's assassin, but Bruno and Solazzo escape from the scene. Aldo returns to his safe house to call Mark Malone about what had happened, although Mark replied in which he wished to talk face to face at the barbershop on Mott Street. Later on, while Mark makes his way towards the barbershop, he bumps into his sister Frankie along the way. When Aldo and Monk meet up, Aldo informs Luca of being dead. Afterwards, Don Corleone is ambushed by Tattaglia gunmen as they shoot him 5 times in the back. Then during the process, Monk is shot in the shoulder and the barber is shot in the chest, which left Aldo remaining to rescue Frankie and taking out the rest of the Tattaglia gunmen. Aldo helps out Fredo Corleone to get Don Vito Corleone to the hospital while on the chase by Tattaglias. Along the way, Aldo learned about Tom Hagen kidnapped by the Tattaglias. Shortly afterwards, Aldo was on guard duty in which he encountered Frankie Malone, who was visiting her injured brother, as well as Tattaglia assassins attempting to kill Don Vito Corleone. Aldo saved Don Vito and Frankie's lives, in which he met up with Michael Corleone to cover the front entrance of the hospital, only to encounter the police alongside Captain Mark McCloskey. Tom Hagen shows up at the scene, warning the captain that he'll pay the consequences if he violates the private detectives from the Corleones. Next, it was New Year's Eve. Aldo went to a party organised by Rosa Morelli. Later on, the party was raided by Sergeant Galtasino and the rest of the police. Rosa is captured by Sergeant Galtasino, so Aldo hunts down Galtasino, in which he secretly passes a few police officers to follow Galtasino to the balcony. Then Aldo threw him off the balcony and a bottle of alcohol to make the situation accidental. Afterwards, Aldo is sent on an assassination order with Comenza to take out Paul Legato, because Sonny Corleone noticed him working with the Tattaglias to set up the Don. When Paul Legato is successfully assassinated, Aldo travels to Los Angeles with Tom Hagen and Rocco to convince movie producer Jack Waltz a role for Johnny Fontaine in one of his upcoming movies. Waltz declined Hagen's deal, so Aldo and Rocco proceeded to kill Waltz's favourite horse named Cartoon. Straight afterwards, Aldo and Rocco silently intrude his home to place Cotton's head in his bed. Next morning, Watts finds the head in his bed, in which he gives Johnny Fontaine a role in his film. So Lotso and Michael Corleone agree to a peace treaty meeting between their families. Michael Sollozzo and Captain McCluskey agree to meet up at Louis' restaurant in Midtown. Michael suggests this is perfect for their vengeance. Tessian mentions that a pistol can be hidden in the bathroom, but someone needs to place it there. Aldo goes over to place the gun in the bathroom and witness Michael kill Sollozzo and Captain McCluskey. Quickly afterwards, Aldo escorts Michael to safety in Sicily. Afterwards, Aldo became a made man into the Corleone family at the Falcon Night. Aldo meets with Frankie to celebrate until Tatali hitmen show up and kidnap Frankie. She is taken to St. Michael Archangel in Brooklyn. Aldo does everything he can to save her, but there's nothing to be done. Frankie Malone is killed by Bruno D'Italia. This caused Aldo to go on a mad rampage for Bruno D'Italia with help from Sonny Corleone, in which Aldo throws Bruno D'Italia into a cremation oven at Tito Morelli's in Midtown. Next, Aldo assists alongside with Sonny Corleone to take over a smuggling ring warehouse run by Artie Manzanera. These actions caused for Sonny Corleone later on to be gunned down by hitmen working for the five families. Aldo experiences the murder as he chases down the assassins over to the Tunnel Club in Hell's Kitchen to learn that Don Barzini is the mastermind behind this from the D'Italia underboss. As Tom Hagen informs Don Corleone about the death of Sonny Corleone, he calls for a truce to allow Michael Corleone to return safely from Sicily. When Michael returns, he honoured Aldo a position of a capo and his right-hand man. Later on, Aldo is sent to the Bowery Hotel in Little Italy to find a rat alongside Monk Malone. As soon as Monk Malone shoots a man in the hotel, it is revealed to be an FBI agent who had been working for Monk. This caused Monk Malone to become a traitor of the Corleones, meaning Aldo forced to execute his old friend. Aldo is sent to kill Salvatore Tessio due to him selling out Michael Corleone, as he reckoned Michael wasn't powerful enough to keep the family going after Don Vito's death. On the day of the baptism, Aldo assists alongside Clemenza to kill Don Stracci, Willie Sisci in shooting Don Cuneo, Rocco Lampone to kill Don Tattaglia, and assisting Al Nero for revenge on Don Bazzini for the murder of his father. With the dons of the five families executed, Aldo took over all the family compounds, as well as conquering all of New York City. Aldo later became the Don of New York City. 3 years later, Aldo was highly respected amongst the mob as he accompanied Michael Corleone to Havana, Cuba for the business deals with Harmon Roth. Whilst escaping the chaos following Castro's revolution alongside his underboss Dominic, Michael and Fredo Corleone, Aldo was shot in the neck by the sniper, causing him to drop dead at the age of 34. By the time of his death, Aldo committed 30 murders. Lucas Assassin, Joe Caltasini, Paulie Gatto, Bruno D'Italia, Marty Malone, Salvatore Tessio, Don Carmine Cuneo, Don Victor Stracci, Don Philip D'Italia, Don Emilio Barzini, Bobby Marcolini, Nicholas Klaus, Mario De Bellis, Ronnie Tosca, Luciano Fabri, George Jackie Giovino, Big Bobby Toro, Pietro Testa, Emilio Barzini Jr., Freddy Nobilo, Tony Bianchi, Donny Marinelli, Mikey Solari, Luigi Fusco, Jack Fontana, Leon Grossi, and Oscar Zavarel. Overall, Aldo Trapani was an amazing character in the Godfather game series, committing 30 murders, becoming the Don of New York City, being the absolute masterpiece that the Corleones needed. Leave a like if you enjoyed this video, subscribe for more, and let me know, what did you think of Aldo Trapani? What other characters would you like to see next? Comment down below, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care, guys.